If you like our videos, consider checking out our Patreon.
Hey everybody, Gunnar and Bird here. We're here with another one of the worst movies on YouTube.
And it was a bittersweet for this one.
Yeah, this is one of those ones that, like, you know, I'm into this, I'm digging its awfulness, and now it's just blah. And then it goes on too long.
Right.
But whatever, it is 1987, I think, Night Screams.
Vintage 1987, dude.
Yeah, well, we'll get into all the vintage 1987-ness of it later. But first, why we thought this movie was going to be awesome? Well, one of the reasons, because in the first 3 seconds, it starts with a chick changing in a locker room, so we got nudity.
Right.
First 3 seconds of the fucking movie.
And when you start your film, in the first 3 seconds you get nudity, you're like, oh.
And then it cuts to this couple watching this as a movie. So the chick getting naked in the locker room is a movie that this couple is watching.
Right. And it turns out to be a theme.
Yeah, kind of.
You know?
But yeah. And then we cut back to the movie where this chick is shaving her legs in a sink, which doesn't look comfortable or sanitary.
But like from far away, I'm looking at it, I'm like, dude, has he shaved cream in her bum? It looks like she's shaving.
No, that was just
it's
her granny
hard
panties.
To shave your butt, you know what I mean? Like, have you tried to ever shave your butt? Like, just getting back, I'm like afraid to cut something because you can't really find where the cut is. You're just running around with a blood butt.
So it cuts back to the couple and then back to the fucking movie where we have, you know, this fucking fencing dude come out
right.
and stab the fucking chick in the fucking neck. Eh.
It was the great fencing match.
And I'm like, okay, see, fucking awesome. Right. I'm all about this.
Action. Things happening, you know?
And then it cuts back to the couple where the dude goes out to check the barbecue.
Do you think the coals are ready yet?
Oh, I better go check.
He goes out to the barbecue. He has no fucking lights outside. Fucking, the barbecue's definitely not on because he puts that burger on it and it ain't going psst.
It does nothing happen.
No smoke, no goddamn nothing. And then it cuts like
it's one of them smokeless grills.
Inside where, you know, the chick is still watching the movie and then she gets stabbed.
We need to point out how glorious this guy's mustache was, though, you know?
Well, he was kind of Kmart John Holmes.
He was. He was a little Sam Elliott. It was perfect, dude.
So Kmart John Holmes comes in and finds his woman dead.
Beth! Oh, my God.
Police, I want to report a murder.
I would never rock that, though. Would you ever try that?
And then get stabbed.
Honey, no!
Can you do that, though? I've never seen you.
No,
really
I can't. I can't really grow a mustache really well.
Puberty went halfway. It was like, nah.
And then it cuts to the fucking killer playing chopsticks. Bing, 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 bing. And I was expecting to see fucking Tom Hanks and Robert Loggia fucking come out and do that. Bullshit.
Hey, Big wasn't, but why was a good movie? Fight you to the death.
Until you think about it, being real creepy about that.
Yeah.
The lady basically fucking a little kid.
Right. We're gonna look past that. You know?
But anyway.
I mean, like, he was really a big dude.
His mind, he was getting statutorily raped in his mind.
True.
True.
Loja.
But anyway, right? So
doing the chopsticks,
and then it cuts to the opening credits, and this amazing, amazing song that plays with all of its synthesizer, guitar, 80 goodness.
Bring that shit home. Didn't you feel like you were back then? Oh, we were a little. But you know what I mean?
It was 87, so we were like, you know, between the ages of 7 and like 9.
We were too young to be at clubs.
Well, yeah,
shit,
obviously.
Listening to this shit.
And then it cuts to this football game where we get some football trash talking.
Up your ass, star.
Up yours! I'm gonna run over your face!
Come
fucking cheerleaders. We get, like, you know, the home team cheerleaders, and then we get the other cheerleaders that are very fancily fucking dressed. They, like, got tails and shit on their fucking cheerleader uniforms.
Yeah, they took time on that shit.
And then we cut to this cop and his partner pulling up to this gas station slash diner to get coffee.
Oh, that's where I want to go eat. A gas station slash diner.
Yeah.
Okay, rookie, stay here. I'll get us a couple cups of coffee.
I'll go with you.
No. Stay here, hang
on. But then anyway, he goes up to the door to talk to the cook.
Hi, Jake.
Hi, Johnson. What's up?
Nothing much to worry about. Two convicts escaped from over at Leavenworth. They were seen heading this way, so if you see anything, I'd appreciate a call.
I'll keep a lookout. Maybe close up for the day.
Not a bad idea. Where's Lily? I'll let her buy me a cup of your lavender coffee.
And then he gets fucking blown the fuck away.
Yeah.
By Kmart Hank Williams Jr.
Are you ready for some football and murder?
And what's great is he comes out and he's like saying all this shit and like getting down into his stance. Boom!
You asshole cop!
Nice shot, fuckface.
Boom! So he shoots at the other partner.
Not very smart to put the shotgun
by your dick.
On your balls.
And he shoots the cop car until the cop car explodes and the dude's on fire. So he's...
For a minute.
And then he makes his buddy fucking rubber gunner, whatever the fuck his name is,
really sure.
Come out and fucking shoot him.
Plenty of times where this guy was like, rubber, 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 and I was like, who is it?
And then it cuts back inside the diner where there's this one guy and then like the two fucking crazy bad guys, right? And they're right. Holding Kmart Daryl Hannah and the cook fucking hostage.
You got them both. Fucking hey, party time.
Hey, little girl, it's party time.
So, you know, the crazy guy, Hank Williams Jr., he goes right. Crazy.
He really
crazy. And he fucking shoots the cook.
Oh, you bastard!
Let's take her with us.
Let's go.
Fuck you, asshole!
Take her with me, Snake.
I said, let's go!
And the fucking chick.
Why you gotta kill the cook?
And then the fucking dude... The one dude in the leather jacket's all like, rah, rah, rah.
Fuck. I did not bust out of that hole to take your shit.
And then fucking Hank Williams just goes all fucking crazy and just starts shooting up the fucking place. Guys! Guys! Guys!
Yeah, so like, at some points, dude, when they were close up to fucking his face, he looked like Liam Neeson. From, like, you know, take the picture off.
No, yeah, that was, like, way later on, whenever he was in the dark room in the mirror, but we'll get into that later. But, okay, so, dude gets all pissed off at crazy guy, takes off his leather jacket and spits on it.
Yeah, on his
hands. This amazing, amazing fight scene happens. Oh, my God, because he tries to take a swing at dude.
From a mile away.
Yeah. So, dude throws him up against the wall, you know, fucking...
Gage!
You know, blood splatters on the fucking wall.
What it reminded me of was a Peter McNeely versus Mike Tyson. It was like, bing! Mike Tyson's over here. He's like, ooh, ah, ooh! You know?
And then the dude fucking hits him again, knocks blood the other fucking way.
And so he's hitting him with fucking Iron Man-like punches.
My favorite part of this movie is about to happen. He goes to throw him out the fucking window, right?
Yeah.
So he's like, ah! And it stops. Like, he stops. Like, they cut a little too early. So you see the actor, like, stop.
Right.
And then it cuts to, like, him getting thrown out the window, but the dude now has blonde fucking hair.
Right, what the
fucking
fuck?
Amazing.
Dude, that guy threw him through that window so hard, his fucking hair changed over.
Yeah.
Maybe it scared the shit out of him. It was just going, like, it was in the phase of turning white.
And then it cuts to a male locker room where we see a fuck ton of tidy whities. Which I guess I'm glad we're seeing tidy whities, because we've seen a lot of balls, like, bare fucking balls recently. So I'm glad at least they're covered by some cotton.
Cotton! How many balls have you seen lately?
Have we seen?
Yeah. Besides your own.
Gay Jesus.
Oh, yeah. Gay Jesus.
12 shots for the loaded.
Yeah, a lot of balls there.
Pot Zombies 2. Remember the very beginning of that that made us quit with this? Blag, blag, blag! Just taking balls flopping. Yeah.
I dated my dreams. Nightmares all day. Thank you.
So whatever.
Sure, they feel good about it.
Like, now we give this balls, now they give this dork ball fucking Russell a wedgie.
Are you guys ready or what?
Well, yeah, well, he was wearing his sister's panties.
And then we cut to the cheerleaders' locker room where they're just talking and it doesn't really fucking matter.
Well, you were more upset that they were more clothed than the dudes. The dudes were more all naked. You were like, ah, come on.
No, what I was saying was what's pretty fucked up is it doesn't matter. I'm not even getting into that now.
What? About the dudes?
About the nudity. About how, like, it's all from movies that people in this movie are watching.
Well, we made, I mean, like, it continues to have the whole stupid
thing. Yeah, it fucking does. But whatever, it doesn't matter because it cuts outside to Russell dancing.
Right.
He's like... And then he gets on the ground and he's all...
No, and he's writhing.
When he's all caught by muscle dick that's dressed like you should be in sleepaway camp.
I thought you were with your mummy and daddy.
That's where I'm going.
And then
he's always brooding. He's brooding more than Anakin Skywalker.
Well, then he has to take some pills. He's all he takes his fucking pills.
Mentor.
And then it cuts to his parents, Kmart, Orson Welles, and fucking his mom outside talking about how proud they are of him and how he's got a scholarship and, oh, they're going away, so don't have any parties.
Listen, honey, you have a good time this weekend, but don't forget to take your medication. I renewed your prescription this morning.
I will, Mom. Haven't I been a good boy all these years? And I love you.
It's just that I worry about you.
God almighty, Beverly, the boy's the best running back in the state. He damn well take care of himself.
It's all right, Dad. She's just worried.
Now, listen, you don't have any wild-ass parties while we're gone either. You're an athlete. You got to take care of your body.
Yeah, I will. Go ahead and go before you miss your meeting. It's just going to be Joni and I and a few. We're going to have a party tonight, get a little get-together, go to Pogo's first.
Remember, you treat them girls like they're little ladies.
Roger.
Oh, his dad looks like his mom made it with a fucking, with a teddy bear. Because he's just, he's, you know, like a rough grouse.
So, we cut to the two psychos wandering around in the woods, and they find this huge fucking house.
Yeah, that was big.
Yeah, it was a big fucking house.
Right.
But whatever. It cuts from that to a bar scene, which was pretty awesome. A bar scene. Where we get this fucking music. About of time bombs and shit.
Oh shit, that's right.
And then we get the fucking biggest dickbag in this fucking movie, the most annoying one, even more annoying than Russell at times, comes busting in like he's goddamn Rerun.
Hey, hey, hey!
And you're like, son of a bitch. And you're like, wait a minute, that's that fucking cunt from goddamn Karate Kid.
He does. He really looks like the dude from Karate Kid. It's not the dude from the Karate Kid, but
it's
looks like it, no.
But he looks like
it. He really does. He looks like the dude who's like, put him in a body bag, Dan, or,
One of them.
No.
He's not in it at all.
I don't fucking think so.
What do you mean you don't think so? I thought you Googled this shit.
You wanted me to look up the red-haired chick. So I didn't look up fucking dudes. I know the dude's not him. Yes, I do
not
fucking know.
Sure.
But whatever, it doesn't fucking matter. Because, you know, he's talking to Muscle Dick about football.
Dave, you're making me crazy with this football stuff. You know that? You got what everybody else wants and you sit here bitching about. Damn it, DB, just because it's what everybody else wants, that doesn't mean it's what I want. I'm tired of this bullshit. I'm tired of it.
Oh yeah, now he does Yoda.
That is where you fail, young Skywalker.
And you were like, that was just, I just see your face, and your face was turning, like, you know what I mean? Your fucking eyes were all turning green and shit. You were...
But then something did calm me down, because it cuts to the nationally famous fucking dance troupe of the Sweetheart Dancers. Here, some of this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the nationally famous Sweetheart Dancers.
Chill out, chill out, chill out. You
great is that band in the background has two keytars in it. Two fucking keytars. And their fucking dances for being nationally famous ain't that fucking great. It's a lot of...
Coming from this fuck that he's a national dancing champion.
I am! I'm fucking Fat Man Jiggle champion of fucking 1984.
Wow! I didn't know that! Hey, the baby think it over. You got me shaking at the knee. Hey, the baby mind your business. Got everybody climbing up a tree. Yeah. You're coming on a little strong. Sticking your face where it don't belong. Now don't you know you're getting to a tight. Shit.
But whatever, right?
That's awesome.
So we cut back to, like, still inside the bar, but, like, you know, there's the two couples, but dude's being a fucking dick.
Cut it out, Doug.
Cut it out, Doug. Or cut it out until I want to get in her pants. You're a horny bitch, and everybody knows it. See, Doug, all you ever do is think about sex, you know? It's disgusting. Why don't you think about something a little bit more rewarding?
Like money.
Hey, just because you're this big, there's no reason to give me shit.
As dudes do.
Yeah, and then we cut the chick watching the dance floor, and I do love the one dude out there is taller than everybody else, like, doing his fucking dancing and stuff. Right. It was fucking great.
That was great. That dude was huge. Really, from the hills has eyes. You're telling me the one who's really tall?
Yeah, he was talking to everybody else on the dance floor. And then it cuts from that to a fucking slow song, which is fucking great because the band's still playing this crap slow song. I see you standing over. And then we got dude, you know, Yoda dickbag, having a conversation with chick, and he seems like he's having a hard time concentrating on dancing and delivering his lines at the same fucking time.
I think it'd be good for us just to go out without the pack. Yeah.
Really? You want to go out with me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, like, what kills me is that, like, sometimes they put music where the music, I mean, like, where obviously where the music should be, and then other times they don't put the music where it fucking should be. You know?
Well, no, sometimes they just, there was no music. Sometimes where there really should have been music, there just wasn't.
And they just couldn't afford
it. But there was, no, there was music in it throughout.
There was music, but, you know? Not, you know what I mean, like, score, whatever.
There was.
Some?
Yes, there was. But whatever, it doesn't matter because the kids go back to that big, huge house the psychos were at.
Right.
It's fucking Muscles McDickbag's parents' house.
Murder McRoscoe.
Yeah.
You know that one.
So they're there to party, and then Russell comes over and he wants in.
Ugh. TV!
Russell!
Dingleberry! Thought I might see him with the band.
Dingleberry! There is no band.
Oh, well. Guess I'll just have to dazzle him all by myself. Because that is the way it is.
And I agreed with the shutting of the door. I was like, do not let Russell in. We're going to have a bad time. They're going to have a bad time. You know what I mean?
But they let him in, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
So blah, blah, fucking blah. We're skipping over some fucking shit because I wrote a lot of unnecessary notes for this fucking movie.
Remember, Russell was supposed to be the comic relief.
And I guess he was supposed to be like the Shelley from like Friday the 13th, like 5 or what, 4, whatever number that fucking was, or 3 or whatever. It doesn't fucking matter. So whatever. We cut to this dude, he's sitting in a rocking chair, and he gets fucking stabbed by a fireplace poker.
Oh yeah, he was waiting for that chick that we thought was hot, and then she got closer, we were like, boop!
Well, no, she had that weird mom hair.
Mom hair. It was like mushroom shaped.
Yeah.
You know, it went up like this. You know, like an alien.
So whatever. Mom hair here, she fucking leaves, gets in her car, starts driving off, and gets fucking grabbed up by the killer guy.
Right. Right.
So she abandons her car, and we get the typical fucking stereotypical horror movie fucking chase scene.
Where she falls.
And then she, like, crawls under a car, and he drops the fucking car on her.
Which would suck.
Well, obviously.
I would not want a car dropped on me. I want nothing dropped on me, goddammit. Unless it's feathers, or titties, or water. I'll take that. It gotta be lukewarm water. Can't be all freezing as a ball. I ain't doing that goddamn challenge shit.
Okay, but anyway, it cuts back inside to this couple watching porn. So here's more nudity in the movie, inside the movie, but not the original movie. Fucking weird.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm skipping some more stuff. We're just going to cut back to the couple still watching fucking more porn.
Oh, Lord. Yeah. Wish they were for a straight minute. And dude's more interested in that than he was as woman. The woman's like macking on him, and he's just like,
God, she's going to do it again. Odd moves. Hey, Chris, when are you gonna learn tricks like that?
Doug, we've seen this tape. Can't we look at another one?
Look at that bitch.
But then, yeah, anyway, now we cut to mild drinking.
Hey, where are the lemons?
Lemons? We don't need no stinking lemons. Good stuff.
Hey, Joni!
And then now we cut downstairs to the basement in the dark where
Roscoe.
Crazy Kmart Hank Roscoe Williams
Roscoe.
The fucking second fucking is monologuing in this fucking mirror all crazy.
God and man. May not only allow himself to gaze upon the horrible and the questionable, but can also lend his hand to the terrible deed.
Are you ready for your football?
And then he's fucking rubbing dirty fucking water all down his face.
That's not sanitary. He's like, I want extreme pink eye.
And
fuck it.
And then we cut to this fucking couple making out and stuff.
Right.
They leave.
What you get a lot is a lot of making out.
Yeah.
You know, me and him could make out for an hour.
Nobody
or
wants to fucking see that
exactly.
Bullshit.
Exactly.
I don't want to see that fucking bullshit.
I didn't
want to
see them making out in this for an hour.
But know? Whatever. So they
I'm
go.
I'm not saying we should do that to torture them.
They go to a sauna, right? And we get to see dude fucking half-masked.
It'll be
I mean, it's swear to God, it looked like dude
and
was sporting a fucking half-stiffy.
Right, you're right, he was like... Was,
so they get into sauna...
breaking through the tape.
And they start making up.
He used masking tape instead of, like, you know what I mean, like scotch tape. It was just going...
And then blah, blah, fucking blah. We're just going to skip ahead a little bit where they're now making out even more, but like heavier, but not getting naked and not having sex.
Eventually you're just like, dude, get it on. Let's get it on. I'm like, what are you going to do it? Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it.
And then...
What the fuck? Who taught these people how to do it? They're 32 years
old.
Yeah,
I know, dude. I know. But whatever. It cuts to Muscles McDickbag here. He's in the bathroom and he's all having crazy thoughts
right.
about his parents and...
Well, he didn't take his fucking crazy pill.
Yeah, and then...
And, his
and,
parents,
then,
and fucking and his dad, who's, you know, I gotta point out what a dick his dad is the whole way through the movie. And to his mother, you know, his mother's like, oh, I'm concerned about our son. He's like, shut up, damn it. I'm trying to eat my meal. He'll be fine. He'll be fine. And then by...
Yeah,
then,
I mean,
you know,
yeah, whatever. It doesn't
right,
fucking matter.
It doesn't really.
So, whatever.
It's plot.
We cut back to half-masts. Fucking sex scene in the sauna, right?
Do you think he still was? Or they had to, like, cut and readjust?
And then, but, like, as this is going on, it's intercut with a shower scene from another movie because there is no fucking chick in that fucking house that looks anything like that chick fucking showering.
And showering.
And it's all weird. You won't be able to see it, but she's rubbing her boobs all weird, like, has one hand underneath it, you know, like, yeah. Real fucking weird.
Like, it was like, you know, do chicks do that? I don't know. I know what I do with my beanbag. I don't know what they do with their sacks. You know what I mean? What do you call them? I don't know.
Boobs.
But they're just
breasts.
Like, you can call them whatever you
titties.
Want.
Titties.
Yeah. Mm. Sorry, I mean, you were just saying it so much. I was like, wow.
So anyway,
wow.
Fucking sauna's sex chick goes out to the fucking pool and swims for fucking ever.
dude, there's a big fucking pull. I mean, like, she was like, you know, it took a minute, like half the film for her to go one end to the other.
And while she's fucking swimming, it cuts back to half-mast. He's laying in the sauna. Whatever, the killer throws poison onto the rocks and gasses them inside the fucking sauna.
I like the fact that she just got up and left, though. She was just like, yeah. I gave him blue balls, fuck him. And he's there and they're going, ow, my, shouldn't have laid straight on this thing.
I know, and then it cuts back to the fucking chick in the pool where she gets axed in the head.
She turned around. Maybe, I don't know if she tried to flee or what, but it was like, prunk. But I don't know about you, but I'm pretty fast in the water. So if I'm sitting there and I see somebody just going, I'm going to go, whee, and they're going to have to jump in after me. And you don't really get much leverage in the water when you're like going, you drown that motherfucker, end of movie. Ta-da!
But now, I wish it was, but it's not, because blah, blah, fucking blah. Right. It cuts to Bill Clinton fucking slash Matt Damon motherfucker,
yes,
and his chick in a fucking goddamn hot tub, and they're all kind of making out, and he pulls a rubber ducky out of his pants, and they're kissing and bleh.
Dude, can you imagine real Bill Clinton doing that shit, pulling a rubber ducky out of his shit, going, and you're like, yeah, no, Bill, please.
And then whatever, Bill Clinton, Matt Damon fucking decides he's going to get out because he wants to eat. Well, actually, he says this shit first.
Yeah, well, I'm hungry.
Oh, for food, really? I'm going to go get something to eat. I'll be right back.
Go give me a drink, okay?
Well, he said he wanted to eat, and then he went downtown for some sushi.
But then he goes into the house to make a fucking, from scratch, fucking burger. It was like, you don't think they have anything else, like, you know, that'd be easier and take less time so you can get back to the fucking?
Yeah, what the fuck is with these guys not preheating their shits?
I know,
preheat your shits, guys!
He just throws it on there and whatever, and it's slowly, lightly smoking.
It's like my woman, she does that shit all the time. It's like, I just want to make a pizza. Yeah. She turns it on and throws it in right away, and I just, I don't get there. It's like, you're stupid. This is why we don't let you cook.
But anyway.
She'll never see this episode.
Dude slams Bill Clinton, Matt Damon's face against the fucking grill.
As we've all wanted to do at one point.
And then pulls Sons of Anarchy and stabs him in the back of the fucking head with a fucking grill fork.
Right, but, you know, took a minute for him to go. But, bahoo-ha.
And then whatever, it doesn't fucking matter. It cuts to fucking Kmart Hank Williams fucking Jr. fucking choking out blonde chick in the fucking basement.
Right.
Kill me. Cut her throat. Spill her blood. Cut her throat. Demand. Cut her throat. Dorian.
And then he kills his buddy with a plastic bag.
This miserable runner.
Oh, wait, like he objected or something. I don't know, he said something. I can't remember, but like, he was like, bam, bam, bam. He went,
it doesn't fucking matter, dude. I don't fucking care. We're getting to the point where I'm like, brr. So it cuts inside again, where Russell's dancing in the dark.
Water, water, it's not my domain. I'll see the tears flow, I'll watch the flood stain.
And then he lays himself on the pool table and he's all, and then he gets choked out of the pool cue.
And I was glad to see it. I'm sorry, Russell, but you were annoying.
And then it cuts from that to the chick out in the fucking hot tub.
Right.
When we see something go, we're like, what the fuck is that? But it's a work light, so
right.
UFO? 2 minutes of fucking woof, 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 the fucking light gets thrown into the fucking hot tub and she gets electrocuted. And then blah, blah, fucking blah, Yoda Dick finds the blonde chick down in the basement and he has some acting.
Oh God, please. Lisa. No, Lisa!
Guy who I think is from Karate Kid, but probably not.
And then he gets stabbed in the back.
like the stabbing in the back, you know what I mean? Like that's.
Dude, did we
mention the redhead with the sharp face?
Yes.
She had a very sharp face.
Well, we didn't say anything about her face, but we mentioned her.
But she had helmet hair, sharp face. Her face could have cut glass.
But whatever, we'll get a little bit more of her in a minute because it cuts to fucking Hank and fucking Muscles McDick fighting outside, right?
Wait, which one's Muscles McDick? You're changing names so many times, I don't know who's who.
It doesn't matter.
Muscle McWookie Dick!
They're out there and they're fighting, and fucking Hank's on top of them, like mounting them and stuff. And
ooh, and how did I miss this?
And then fucking Yoda McDick comes out, fucking passes him a knife, and he stabs fucking Hank. He goes into the fucking house where he collapses next to Redhead.
Right. And then she gets up, and she's like, whoa.
Yeah, she starts talking. Yeah, we find out she's the fucking killer for stupid reasons that they repeat multiple times.
She wouldn't let us be together. They were always trying to break us up. I hated him for it.
Hated who?
What the hell? Some parents, who do you think? They weren't nice to me, so I cut them up in little pieces. They were jealous, and they tried to break us up.
She repeats all of it. She was like, I killed him because they were jealous and they wanted to break us up. And he was like, okay, I get it. She's like, they were jealous and they wanted to break us up. He's like, I fucking get it.
So she's on top of him trying to stab him whenever the parents and the cop comes in.
Right.
The cop shoots somebody. It doesn't show you because it's pulling a little spin.
Ooh.
Like a little twist at the end here. So the parents are talking to somebody we see off camera.
Right.
But we can already figure out it's the chick.
You're looking very well today. That's quite an ordeal you went through last night. Police officer wants to speak to you outside.
At first you're like, the son, but then you're like, no.
Yeah, it's the fucking chick. Right, because it cuts to her. Oh, no, first, the parents blame him killing on his hyperactivity.
Right, well, they were like, oh, he's crazy, and we just forgot his pills. I'm like, so you're responsible.
Well, they say this.
Can you give us any idea what happened?
Not really. My son's been on medication for severe hyperactivity ever since he was a boy. He's lost his temper a lot, but...
I understand now.
And then it cuts to, like, you know, the fucking red-haired chick in the hospital. She opens her eyes, looks at the camera, smiles. And then it cuts to fucking credits, right?
Yeah, she did that Cersei smile.
And then it's fucking weird because we have done other movies like this, but the credits are highlights from the movie, like all the death scenes.
They're making you re-watch the movie.
Yeah, we've watched numerous movies that have done this. Right. Why they do it, I don't fucking know.
I mean, and you're like, look, we've seen the movie. We don't want to re-watch your movie.
But what we do want to watch is, at the very end of the credits, we get two fucking trailers, right?
This is almost worthwhile. Like, you should just fast forward to this poop and get to this.
We get to the first trailer, which is Necromancer. Fuck it, I'm just going to let it play.
Just let it play.
College life is one big party. And Julie is a very popular girl.
Why don't we just meet for a cup of coffee and talk or something, huh?
All the guys are after her, and they'll try anything to make an impression. But everything backfires.
I shot him.
No, you haven't.
Whatever we had between us has been over a long time now.
I don't think you can get financial aid if you fail a course in your major.
And Julie's had enough.
Whatever happens inside this room will only help to release the anger within you. I am the demon of vengeance. We disturb thy kingdom.
Something's happened to Julie. She's not quite herself.
Look who's back for more.
And people are starting to notice. Julie is under a spell.
It's a dream. It's not real.
No dream. You can't be afraid.
It's too late.
And must fight herself to defeat the Necromancer.
You were angry and wanted revenge.
Necromancer. Black is the magic. that shows no mercy. Necromancer, starring Liz Caton and Russ Tamblyn.
I'm gonna try to find both of them because we cut to the second one, which is called Family Reunion.
Sutterville is no place to bring the family.
Is Sutterville a real ghost town with real ghosts?
It's Sutterville, and there's no such thing as ghosts.
40 years ago, something terrible happened here.
Town folk were involved in some sort of voodoo or black magic.
Some kind of trick?
Tom's family intended to bypass Sutterville.
Slow down, Dad!
I can't. The accelerator's stuck.
But they were driven to it.
What's happening?
Summoned against their will to a family reunion.
Let's go home.
Now, they are coming apart.
They are home.
In a town that is self-destructing.
Suspect name, Clarence McLaughlin, date of birth, July 19, 1925. Date of death, December 25th, 1948.
Hey, man, put me down! And Dad's nightmares are getting worse. The sins of the father must be paid for in flesh.
With the spilling of your son's blood, you will be given the power to lead our warriors into battle.
The devil works.
Let me go, Dad!
In mysterious ways. Family reunion. They'll be expecting you.
Dude,
it kind of reminded me of having like a whole Children of the Corn kind of. It was like a mishmash of like 1,000 different movies,
but
just cheaply slapped
definitely
together.
Definitely worth checking out.
Kind of had some Troll 2-ness to it.
Troll 2-ness. Yeah.
But whatever.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was that. Movie started out fun, kind of fucking drug, but at the very fucking end, after the credits, we got some more fun.
Right.
So all in all, a pretty okay, I don't want to say decent, a pretty okay one.
Well, by the end, you're rooting for the killer, so.
I mean, it's got to definitely be better than probably next week's Koontz movie.
Oh no.
On that note,
no.
For Gunner and Bird, this has been another one of the worst movies on YouTube.
No.
We'll see you next week for Koontz.
No, we will not. Which one are we doing this right now?
I don't know. Time. We don't know.
I think you said. You were like, hey.
No, remember we went through like a whole bunch of them and was like,
Tightrope 6, a tightrope 7, a tightrope 8.
We might. Who fucking knows, dude? They're all the same fucking movie, so who goddamn knows? We might end up doing Tightrope 4. We might not.
Yeah, we might finish that whole bottle.
No!
Come here, I want to look at the end of your nose.
Why you want to look at my nose, DB?
Yep, just what I figured. You know, by looking at your nose, it leads me to believe that possibly you haven't been circumcised yet.
Why don't you suck on it?
Yeah, you'd love it, wouldn't you?
So you guys like going steady or what?
And yet?
No, but I'm gonna have to. You don't have to do anything you don't want to.
You tried dealing with my father. Excuses, man! Dave, you gotta tell your father how you feel. And you gotta tell him now. Tell him you wanna start making your own decisions in life. Tell him you wanna stop living for him and start living for yourself. But tell him now.
I can't,
now!
Damn it!
Well, you got the chance, now!
Hey, all right, the host with the most returned. Hey!
Hey, darts, anyone?
Why not? Hey, want some wine, Dave?
Come on, feel the peer pressure, Dave.
Come on.
Damn it, Russell, why don't you pay attention for once in your life?
Sorry, Davey, I was just going...
Shut up! Easy, Dave.
Shut up!
David?
Is there anyone I haven't pissed off tonight?
No.
Hey, food, Russell? Fancy a sandwich?
So good of you to ask, TV.
Good.
Hurry up with that wine, woman.
Yeah.
Come on. You really know how to dance. That's what I like about.